India is promoting Make in India movements in the every sector, especially in the defense. Because recently Philippines bought the Make in India Brahmos anti-ship missile defense system. The Mauritius is also buying the Dhruv MK3 reconnaissance helicopter. And the India also gave $100 million defense line of credit to the Mauritius. Because we told the Mauritius that the whatever the defense item you required, you can purchase it by using this $100 million defense line of credit. And the other nations, the other ASEAN nations, African countries are also interested to buy the Indian defense systems. We will be going to talk about those in the later part of our discussions, which are the defense system they are interested in. Some of the South Asian countries are also interested to acquire the Indian defense systems. Hello everyone, welcome to the Power Academy. In this topic, we will going to discuss about how the India promoting its Make in India initiative to increase its defense export to the other friendly nations. India has also come out with a list of the 150 defense items which India have told its friendly nations that they can purchase among these 152 defense item. And the nations are also interested to buy these kinds of items. And that includes these missile systems, which is the Akash surface to air missile system, Astra air-to-air missile system, Nag and the Pinaka missile systems, and the Barak missile systems, which India and the Israel were developed jointly. So now let's know a little about these missile systems. What are these missile systems and why the countries are interested to buy this missile system? First, talk about the Akash surface to air missile system. The Narendra Modi government had approved the export of the Akash surface-to-air missile systems, which was indigenously developed by India. The Akash has recently developed to a range of 25 km and can engage the special targets at the same time in all weather conditions. Over 96% of the Akash equipments are the Indian build. The Indian Navy inducted it in 2014 and Army in 2015. The countries like United Arab Emirates, Vietnam, Philippines have expressed to purchase this defense system. By the way, the Vietnam is more interested on the extended versions of the Akash missile systems, which is 90 km. But it is under development. That is why the Indian government advised or actually told the Vietnam government that wait for the system to come into a market, wait for the systems to go through the development process, then we will going to sell you these defense systems. India is willing to give those defense systems to the Vietnam. So now the two countries, the United Arab Emirates and the Philippines, is actually interested in 25 km Akash surface to air missile system. And now the second one is the Astra air to air missile. The Astra is the India's first beyond visual range air-to-air missile developed by DRDO, Defense Research and the Development Organization. This missile possesses the exceptional maneuverability and the supersonic speed, which is designed to engage and destroy the aerial targets. The sophisticated air capabilities of the missiles enables it to engage the multiple high-performance targets. The Indian Air Force and the Navy are the primary users of this Astra missile system. These missiles have been incorporated with the Sukhoi 30 MKI, and the MK2 model have the range of the 160 km. India and Russia are working together to create the Astra MK3 versions, which is a future model that can be beyond the range of the MBDS Meteor BVRAM. BVRAM means beyond visual range air-to-air missiles. By the way, the Meteor's range is 200 km. So India is trying to go beyond the 200 km. So that is why India is developing these systems with the collaborations with the Russia. And the next one is the Nag and the Pinaka missile system. Pinaka is a rocket system basically, but the Nag is a missile system. The Nag is a third generation anti-tank guided missiles developed by DRDO. The DRDO, I have already mentioned, the Defense Research and the Development Organization. And this system is based upon the Israel's Spike missile systems. The Spike is also an anti-tank guided system. And the Nag can be launched from the ground and the air. It has a range of 4 to 7 kilometers with an navigation systems for pinpoint accuracy. The final test of the Nag was successfully completed in 2020. And the Indian Army is ready to induct these systems. And the India has also tested the helicopter versions of the Nag missiles, which is Helena. The Nag missile was developed in India as a part of the Ministry of the Defense Integrated Guided Missile Development Program, which also includes the Agni, Akash, Trishul, and the Prithivi. And the Pinaka is also a multiple rocket launcher designed by the DRDO, which is truck mounted with a range of 37.5 km. But the new enhanced version has a range of 75 km. It has the ability to strike within 10 meters of where it is aimed, allowing the army to destroy the terrorist camp and the enemy post in which the country is fighting against. So that is why these missile systems is very important for the India to defense against the terrorist camps, which is in the country called the Pakistan. And the India is also trying to extended the range of the Pinaka missile systems up beyond the 100 km, because the missile systems are very much required for the protections, for the rapid fire, rapid developments of the war situation. So that is why the Pinaka is a very important missile systems for Indian Army. So now the next one, and then the last one, is the Barak 8 missile system. The Barak 8 missile developed jointly by the Israel and India, and that could also be exported on the same lines as the Brahmos. Recently, the Barak 8 has been Morocco actually expressed the interest to buy the Barak 8 missile system from Israel. So Barak 8 is capable to counter the airborne threats up to 70 kilometers. It has an excellent maneuverability in the terminal phases. So that is why India is also using the Barak missile system to protect its aircraft carriers. That is why the Barak missile system is very important. And why India is promoting its missile system, there is a reason. That is why India is promoting these missile systems. India always been a missile importer, mainly from the Russia, but in the recent times, India diversified its defense equipment procurement. And the India is now buying from the USA, France, and the other countries. Other countries like the Spain, Italy, these are the countries. But recently, the Indian government started promoting Make in India program aggressively in the defense sector. That is why so many defense subsystems procurement has been banned, to promote the homegrown defense startups and the industries. And the Indian government is also holding some expensive procurement from the USA and the Russia, like the P8I, which is Poseidon. Poseidon 8II stands for India, and the MiG-29 acquisition. Now the Ministry of the Defense advisory, the three army corps not to purchase, advise the three army corps not to purchase the items, the defense items from outside, to procure the defense item from the Indian industry. And the due to this curtailment of the defense import, India is saving the billions of foreign reserves. It is also important for the Atmanirbhar Bharat initiative. India is trying to make itself the self-dependent on the defense sector, because India's defense industry is huge. India's defense needs is huge. Because India is facing the two front war against the China and the Pakistan. Recently, Argentina, Egypt, Malaysia has shown their interest to buy the HAL Tejas Mk1A aircraft, which can be used for the training as well as the tactical fight, the fight against the enemy. The Philippines already purchased the Brahmos, as you know. They are also interested on purchasing the HAL Dhruv Mk3 along with the Dornier 228 aircraft for the reconnaissance. The reconnaissance the South China Sea regions, which China claimed as their own. the UAE, Vietnam, Indonesia, Malaysia, Uganda, they are all interested in the BrahMos missile system. So it is the Indian government which is doing everything to promote its defense industry. In 2020, the recent government has set a goal for the Indian defense industry to export 5 billion by 2025. It is also a renewed push for the indigenous manufacturing, and the diplomatic outreach could mean India will be in the position to export the more missiles and the other weapon system to the other friendly countries. So that is why the India is promoting the Make in India initiative, the Atmanirbhar Bharat initiative, to earn more for the 1.4 billion people. India's population is huge. That is why India have to diversify its income. So these are all the reasons. Now we have reached to our question part, and our today's question is, at which of the following places is the India's National Defense University being set up? The first option is Medak in Andhra Pradesh. Second option is Amethi, Uttar Pradesh. Third option is Gurgaon, Haryana. Fourth option is Kasargod, Kerala. And the next question, I have added an extra multiple choice question, which is Admiral Gorshkov, the Soviet aircraft carrier imported by India, is now named. The first one is INS Vikrant, second one is INS Vikramaditya, the third one is INS Virat, fourth one is INS Vishal. If anyone have any doubt about this topic, or if anyone wants to ask me any questions regarding any topic, or if you want me to tell on the other topics, then you can mail me to my email address, which I enlisted, which is twin.power.academy@gmail.com. Thank you very much. Thank you for your attention.